Hey everybody, welcome to Nioh. So, first game I've ever recorded with a capture card. Let's dive right in. Don't have quite any idea how exactly I'm going to handle the uploading and whatnot. I think I'm just going to record one big old block and kind of just maybe dice it up, I don't know. I'll figure it out. Yeah. The far east lies Zipangu, a land brimming with golden palaces and sparkling jewels. Kublai Khan, ruler of the Mongol Empire, sent a large army there, but the warriors of Zipangu used miraculous stones to put up strong defenses. Okay. So the Queen England's a bitch. Got it. The Tower of London is an imposing fortress built by King William I in order to keep London safe. It has since gone on to be used as a prison for traitors and execution grounds for criminals. Londoners believe that if the many crows living within the walls were to abandon it, the tower would collapse and London itself would be destroyed. Towers held together by pigeon shit. Game. The rock walls look pretty. It seems to be locked. Fuck chairs. Fuck furniture. Fuck, there's swords right there. Oh, okay, this is equipment. Melee weapon. Bastard sword. Attack. You know. Oh. Change to attack. Heart, strength, and skill. Okay. Damage reduction 1.2%. Defense plus 3. It's like I got caught one night fucking somebody's wife. Ow. Guard key usage. Strong attack break. Critical. Is there a way to... Reduces key... Oh, when your health is low. Way in there. Ooh, did you drop something else? Ah, dungeon key. Covers health when used. This hard lozenge features several varieties of medicinal herbs mixed with fine honey. Well, I don't want to use it. Don't want to use a healing item now. Come on. At least the medicine restored quite a bit of health. Hey! Got some pants. Toughness plus one. Oh. Well, I probably would have died from that one hit, so... Battle axe. Minor weapon. You know, flimsy, flat-ass piece of metal or no, you got a big fuck-all piece of iron attached to a fucking stick.
Tomorrow's execution takes place. We will get our hands on a couple of simple sea dust.
Something tells me the barefoot guy is... Oh. Hey, how's it going?
Ah,
Oh, that's a drop-off? Do I get a silly hat? I get a dapper hat. Oi there, governor! I had to chop your fucking balls off with me axe! I went up. What if I go down more? Ooh. Better coat. Wait, wasn't there a guy here? Must have been a light on the wall. Ah, okay. Medicine, stone. Simple rock is the perfect size for throwing. Throw it at enemies to deal damage. Human item drop rate. I like drop rates. So, what's out here? Check inside first. Here, you got extra drop rate. What do you find? Well, you get mostly, better parry, strong attack key damage. Recurrent damage from fire down. Let's see, this is a... That looked like a different kind of axe. There's a battler. So, strong attack, key damage. Plus 7 points. Familiarity damage bonus. Strong attack break. I like the sound of that. I have no idea exactly what it is, but... I guess you get better... Oh, new pants. Oh, more life. That's just an all-around better deal. Oh, God, I'm gonna be sorting through loot for ages, aren't I? Oi! I'll gather up a bit of stuff first before I start. Oh, please tell me I didn't get both of them. Ooh, two medicine and a new battle axe. Now I lose my toughness. I don't want to lose my toughness. Close combat key damage. And parry plus 13. And strong attack break. I killed your friend! Oh, you have a sword. So we got a new bastard sword. Break plus 13, parrying. Quick attack, key reduction. Reduces key used when you quick attack. think we'll try this one, because this has this. That just sounds better. I don't want to reset enemies. Oh. Ah, okay, so there's two ways into here. All righty. Come on, fucker. What the? Why didn't you fucking dodge? Strong attack break. Equipment drop rate. Okay. Come on, buddy. No, your friend can stay the fuck behind. Oh, crap. Oh. I fucked up. I fucked up. I fucked up. I fucked up. So do the armored guys come back? Yeah, they do. Maybe not open that door. So do I not leave a... I guess I don't leave a corpse. Oh, those... Oh, if that's the case, might as well... As long as those guys don't, you know, turn around and see me. Alright, I was off... You, good sir, get your fucking ass over here. I have a top hat. Well, it's kind of a top hat. I'm more dapper than you. Okay. Well, at least there's gonna be plenty of medicine lying around. Alright, you! Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. Come on, Count Fuckelstein. Ooh, did I get some... Sweet. Receive damage from an attack... Oh, critical. Oh, I can see it affects... Okay. Probably shouldn't be wearing such heavy armor. Damn it, a great helm, though. Fuck it, I have to wear it. I have to be full metal retard. Quick attack break. Okay, now I can be full metal retard. My checkpoint bit's already there. I guess since I'm going in some direction, I might as well... Might as well snatch up. Make sure I got max medicine. Am I just so fat? Or those things fall apart when I run into them, or am I just so goddamn fat now? I am a silly English knigget. Is that an armored guy? Actually, okay, so weapons don't weapons don't affect equipment rate. Just your... It's just how fat your armor is. And I have the fattest armor. How can I not wear the fattest armor? Come on, it's the fattest armor! That looks kind of bossy. I want more stuff. Give me more stuff. That's one of those. Oh, to avoid the night, and then you could sneak up there and drop on the one dude's. Hi, Derek. How are you? He was kind of squishy for somebody who had a name and a health bow. Hi. I am Evil McBarefoot. Wait, your mouth was sewn shut? Kind of? Oh, damn it, Derek. Why was his mouth sewn? Ow. Charge me. Yeah, just play it safe. Charge me. Come on. Come on. Come on, Spikey. Ow. Living weapon. Oh, they're guns. Don't think that's a... God damn it, they hit my plate mail. I think I'm fucked. Rafat armor, it betrays me. Oh, I got a magic feather? Okay, I am one burly, physics-defying motherfucker. I'm quite buoyant. To offset the plate mail. Yay! Sure it isn't. I don't see why they try bothering doing that shit. Blocked scene. Before I begin my preparations for landfall, I leaf once more through that curious book I chanced upon. Recorded inside are the memoirs of a sailor who had once paid a visit to the land of Zipangu. Precisely how this document wound up in the hold of the ship when its author clearly belonged to the crew of a different boat is beyond me, but here I am poring over its pages all the same, and not for the first time this voyage, I may add. What fascinated me above all else was the memoir's many accords of Zipangu's diverse armor and weaponry. Sword, attribute, heart plus one, single-handed sword, primarily a slashing weapon with a wide attack range, can also be used for thrusts and has a long reach. This is a well-balanced weapon that's easy to use. Dual sword, skill plus one. A pair of swords, one held in each hand. A single blow from either blade lacks power, but they enable rapid consecutive attacks when used together. They make an excellent choice of weapon when surrounded by numerous assailants. Body, for spear. A long-handled weapon tipped with a blade, its superior reach enables rangy sweep attacks. However, it will ricochet wildly if struck against a wall, making it a poor weapon for enclosed spaces. Axe, stamina plus one. A weapon with a thick, heavy blade on one end, its weight makes it a slow weapon to swing, but also gives it considerable power. Enemies find its attacks difficult to deflect. Kasaragama, dex one. A weapon that combines a sickle and a weighted chain, mastery of this unusual weapon requires a deep understanding of many special techniques. The sickle allows for quick strikes and close range, and the chain and weight can be thrown to add range to the weapon's offensive repertoire. I want to use the Kasarigama. Because Team Ninja worked on this. The Kasarigama was awesome in Ninja Gaiden 2. Although I highly doubt it just got to anything close to how it was in Ninja Gaiden 2. I could just be like all current. I have this odd feeling a lot of people go, I kind of want to go current Thor Smash. But I'm not sure. And I don't exactly know what these stats do. I want to do this just because I... I like Kusarigamas. Or Kusarigamas. Choose your preferred weapon. The sailor from the memoir seems to have spent quite some time in Zipangu and succeeded in keeping the company of samurai. He writes in detail of establishments in Zipangu called dojo, where people, including samurai, congregate for instruction in the martial disciplines. Just reading the sailor's vivid accounts, I feel as though I'm there in the flesh, watching these warriors as they train. The samurai is a master of many armaments and trains for combat in every imaginable scenario. If I were to use another weapon, which one would I choose? We have the sword to deal with everyday situations. And then when something's particularly annoying, we squash it with the axe. The memoir also asserts that samurai are knowledgeable in the martial arts. First, they know which fighting stance to use in each situation, high, mid, or low. Second, after each attack, they ready themselves for the next strike by focusing their ki, or inner energy. Third, once their ki is readied, the samurai can use purification techniques to rid their surroundings of malevolence. Oh, goddammit. Malevolence everywhere! I know not how to explain it, but I feel as though I have some innate ability to grasp all these concepts and have experimented many times with each technique. Sir, what are you doing? Purging malevolence! Or actually, purging malevolence, laddie. Fuck the pain away. The memoir says Zipangu is home to 8 million gods and other deities. Exactly how this figure was derived, I can only imagine, but as I cast my gaze at the shore, I'm struck by the sensation that some mystical power has been keeping watch over me. It is an energy that reminds me of Sarose? They'll probably say it at some point. I pull out the memoir once more and survey each page until I arrive at the guardian spirit that best match the force I am sensing. Kato. Strength plus one. A wolf and guardian spirit of fire element strengthens the attack power, strengthens the attacking power of those in its protection. Isanade? I think, I'm gonna butcher the fuck out of these names, just saying. Spirit one. A shark and guardian spirit for the water elemental amplifies the ability of those in its protection to sense enemies. Huh. I wonder if that gives me, like, there's somebody on the other side of that rock. Skill 1. A hawk and guardian spirit of the wind elemental increases the evasive ability of those in its protection. Begin the tutorial mission. What? This dojo is a training ground for samurai. It is filled with the blood, sweat, and tears of the uncounted warriors who polish their techniques within its walls. These long traditions and secrets are handed down from generation to generation of samurai. Okay. Follow the instructions and get a feel for the controls. Alright. Quick attack fast, doesn't consume much ki, but only causes light damage, strong, powerful, consumes more, and lowers your guard. If your ki reaches zero, you'll not be able to attack until it recovers. Okay. Lock on, switch target. Let's see, high stance. High stance emphasizes attack power, allows for powerful techniques. Mid stance is good for defense, and has a wide range of techniques, is easy to use. Low stance is good for dodging, it doesn't consume much ki, and also maintains your guard as you move. Key pulse. R1 when blue light gathers around after an attack. Key pulse recovers your key. The amount varies based on your timing. The maximum amount is determined by your key gauge. Yokai Realm and Purifications. Yokai Realm. Another world born from the yokai. When you're in the yokai realm, your ki recovery speed is greatly reduced. Conversely, the power of the yokai themselves are enhanced there. Purify recovers the maximum amount of ki from a successful ki pulse in the yokai realm. It also cleanses the defilement of the yokai realm from your person, restoring you to normal. I like this already. Come here, boy. Who's your daddy? I'm your daddy. shoot. Press R2 while holding L2. Switch ammo type. Square for normal, triangle for special. Operate a zoom. Ready your ranged weapon with L2. Press R2 to shoot. Use right stick to move the reticle around. Switch between different types of ammo. Some enemies have a weak spot. Landing a hit on the weak spot will deal greater damage and break their stance. The middle of the reticle will turn red when pointed at an enemy's weak spot. The rest of the reticle will turn red if you're the closer you are to the enemy. Maybe I'm supposed to hit the bodies. That's one way to reload. Oh. Kimurogi fragment. Splinter of the sacred tree uses a holy vessel and religious rite. Uses up all your Amrita, but allows you to quit a mission and return to the starting point. Fragment of high density Amrita that glows with a faint golden light, as though it contains a firefly. Use it to receive 100. No. Oops. Living weapons. When a Guardian Spirit Amrita gauge is full, circle triangle, Guardian Spirit skill. While a living weapon is activated, do the same thing. Triggering a living weapon changes the health gauge and key gauge into a living weapon gauge. As long as the living weapon gauge is active, you are impervious to damage and your close combat attacks inflict more damage. Living weapon gauge decreases over time and when the enemy attacks land. Once the gauge is fully depleted, the effects wear off. While a living weapon is active, perform unique skill. Okay, I mean, the game doesn't have a fucking instruction manual at all, because, you know, why would they make instruction manuals nowadays, I guess? The dinghies have been readied for us to make a landfall. For all I've read on this country, nothing can truly prepare me for what now lies ahead. I put the memoir down and leave my cabin. Kurishima is a tiny island off the coast of Usuki in Kyushu, Bungo Province. There is little in the way of usable land, with a coastline rapidly giving way to cliffs and mountains. Clinging to its edges, their edge is the smallest of fishing villages, its residents eking out subsistence farming on plots carved out from the hills. Their frugal lives stand in stark contrast to the village elder, whose opulent mansion perches on top of the island's tallest peak, strangely oversized for the small island which it overlooks. My beard can only grow stronger with souls. Skill points obtained. Well, Mariner's shirt. Really? I don't have my fat armor anymore. Uchi katana. So katanas, I get heart, strength, and skill. Well, on the bright side, I got pluses to all those. The ladder. Oh, okay. So what if there's money? Hey, little proggy man. Affects life and resistance, poison and paralysis. Mainly affects spears. Hard affects key, swords and bows. How much weight you can carry. Cannons! Wait! I get cannons? What kind of cannons? Probably isn't like Ultima 7 stupid where I can just carry a fucking field piece around. So strength affects axes. Required to activate the special effects of heavier weapons and armor. Required to activate the special effects of more technical weapons and armor. Determines the effect and capacity of your ninjutsu. Determine the effect and capacity of Anmyo magic. Affects the power of your guardian spirit. Well. Oh, life. Oh wait, this only gets one attack. Ooh, 40 HP for that. 10 for this. So I guess it's kind of like DS2 where your health will still go up a little bit per stamina. Ah, okay. So I get a little bit of weight capacity out of that. Key pulse plus 10. Samurai skill points, ninjutsu power. Ninjutsu skill points. magic skill points, and magic capacity. Guardian Spirit Bond. Versus Yokai Realm. Strength? So it's this spirit protection, evasion key usage, equipment drop rate. Ooh. Attack enhancement, win usable time, might, action recovery, tenacity, Amrita gauge rate A+. Offer an item to receive. Oh, sell, basically. Boom. Oh, claim DLC items. Wait. What? What? Why would I have... Oh. Is this some kind of special version I got? No, this is just the normal... Doesn't say it's any kind of special edition. That's weird. Okay. Summon visitor. Ow. Huh. That's... fucking weird. I don't know why I would get that. I'll go with this, since I don't have any. I don't have anything for those slots. Why do I have golden Nioh armor? I'm confused. Oh, elixir. First is said to be made by Kodama tree spirits from nuts and seeds, but the truth is unknown. It only affects those with spiritual strength. Connoisseurs savor its unusual bitter flavor. Yeah, we got the... and rocks. Rock! Oh, okay, so elixir is... So, what's this? Grapple. Grapples an enemy who is out of key, follows up with a powerful attack. Seems cool. Oh, this is for sword. Now I am using a sword. Oh, ninja. Oh, this is key pulse. Now purify yokai realm. Flux 1. Change to another stance on a successful key pulse increases the amount of key recovered. Oh. Okay, triangle for an opponent out of key. Hmm. mid-low only. Follows up combo with a kick that causes a large amount of ki damage. Pronounce EI. EI quick draw. Gathers power, keeping your sword and scabbard. Quick draw and rapid strike. Can only be used when your sword is sheathed. Other training required. Sword key. Disperses key from your sword to stun surrounding enemies. While living weapon is active, hold triangle to quickly slash surrounding enemies. Follows up a combo with a slash while stepping back. High stance only. Activates when you recover full ki from a ki pulse. Raises the damage caused by your next attack. Follows up a combo with a jumping slice. Enables you to use ki pulses even when dodging. I like the sound of the kick. Indomitable Spirit 1. When your health drops to 30% or lower, your ki recovery speed increases. You just walk up, I have a sword, but whap, whap. Oh, hey, the boxes come back. Well, anyway, I'm going to take a quick break. Also, I want to kind of check and make sure, the damn thing actually worked. So, I'll catch you guys next time.